Dancing and prancing, grooving, keep on moving, flying, stop your crying, choosing while you're cruising. Music is the answer to your problems. Keep on moving, then you can solve them. If you feel that you can't take no more, and your feet are headed for the door, gotta keep on dancing and prancing, grooving, keep on moving, flying, stop your crying, choosing while you're cruising. Music is the answer to your problems. Keep on moving, then you can solve them. At 12 midnight, I'll be waiting for you. So don't forget what you have to do. Gotta keep on dancing and prancing, grooving, keep on moving, flying, stop your crying, choosing while you're cruising. Music is the answer to your problems. Keep on moving, then you can solve them. If you feel that you can't take no more,
Jesus fucking Christ, man, I'll be down in a minute. I must admit, I've never owned one of these before.
Play this kind of music before.
What?
I thought you were into Liam Gallagher and Arctic Monkeys and all that.
Oh, yeah, it's not really that kind of thing tonight.
You told me it was a gig.
It's kind of a gig, but it's more like DJs and stuff.
Really? I didn't know you were into all that kind of stuff.
Well, it's New Year's, innit, so the boys fancied it, I guess.
Okay, well, you behave yourself.
What?
Keep your nose out of trouble, if you know what I mean. Don't be doing anything just because the lads want you to do it. Jamie, I mean it. Behave yourself tonight and don't let any of the other lads make you do anything that you don't want to do.
All right, I'm going to go now.
Okay.
All right, I love you.
Love you.
Stupid bitch. Little did she know, eh?
What the fuck are you doing?
What?
Put that away, you bellend. It's broad daylight. Hurry the fuck up.
Oh. Shit, sorry.
Yeah, Sonny and Carl are through there. What are you doing with your baggie, by the way? Do you know how you get in?
I don't fucking know. I thought you'd help me.
Nah, I need a massive shit before I go. There's through there, sort of the magic, if you need a hand.
Mud. What's that? Magic mushrooms or something?
What? No, it's short for MDMA, you gimp. Look, if you want a drink, kitchen's through there. There's vodka in the cupboard.
I know her ex-mum and dad aren't in, but it still feels weird bringing up drugs and shit so casually in the house. I don't know, it's probably because I'm such a fucking virgin to shit like this. I mean, I did have a toke on a zoot once to impress a bird, but I can't say it ended well. I threw up all over her shoes and my mate Sonny ended up fingering her in that bathroom, so admittedly not been too keen to delve into narcotics since then. Thank you. But recently, with the end of university around the corner, it's got me stressing big time. What if nobody makes time for me? What if I've got no mates after leaving university? I mean, you've heard that Blink-182 lyric, nobody likes you when you're 23. Well, nobody liked me at fucking 17, 18, 19, so what chance have I got? I mean, I suppose that's what's driven me here. Something just told me I had to finally have the balls to come on and out with my mates and stop being such a pussy. And I know for a fact I didn't do uni properly. All my mates from home moved into halls and yet I stayed at home. Why? I'm at home watching Gogglebox with my mum, and meanwhile they're all at parties, chatting to birds and making friends, just because I was too scared to move out, too scared to go out, and too scared to try anything new. Well, I'm not having it anymore. So tonight, I'm going to go toe to toe with all of them, and I'm going to show them that I'm a mate that's worth having, a mate to make time for. Even after uni, where we've all got fucking jobs and shit. So yeah, this is where you meet me today. As a man who has, perhaps mistakenly, agreed to snort copious amounts of MDMA with his mate at New Year's Eve techno rave. Fucking hell, saying out loud makes me feel a bit sick. I haven't got the first idea I'm gonna get my drugs past a bunch of beefed up security guys, but I suppose I'm in good hands. These lads have done it before, so I'm inclined to trust their methods. Speaking of, let's see what they're up to. What the fuck?
See, man, it's what you have to do.
Have to do?
Yeah, worked for us the last few times.
But do you not think there's something inherently gay about getting your dick out in front of your mate?
Not for all day.
Wait, so let me get this straight. You've all sat round with your kecks off in front of each other and sellotaped the bag of MDMA to your dick?
Yeah.
There's no way that's not gay.
And so what if it is, you fucking bigot? If you're gonna tape it up, well, the only way?
Well, it's not the only way.
What's the other way?
Shoving up your arse.
Yeah, chuck us the sellotape. By the way, while you were gone, Sonny told me this little technique is known as gooching it, so there you go. I then remembered I used to play Minecraft with this boy not 4 years ago, and I question what he's become.
Yeah, that's true, Jamie. You don't want to risk the dogs finding it.
Dogs? Well, like police dogs?
Oh, yeah.
You didn't say fuck all about any police dogs.
Yeah, can you shit yourself and not come?
Well, yeah, you're right. I'm not fucking coming now, am I?
Hey, chill out. It'll be fine as long as you gooch it. Plus, after I've heard who's coming tonight, you're not going to want to miss it.
Who?
Hannah Fisher.
Really?
Yeah. Broken up with her man as well.
Fuck off. Easily one of the fittest birds in our year. I literally think I love her. She's that one I was on about before. The one I smoked that zoot with who supposedly got... Oh, son, you better not finger her again.
No promises. Nah, it's fine. I know how much you fancy her, she's all yours.
Wait, I've just thought though, surely I can't sellotape the drugs to my knob now then?
Why?
Well, what if something happens between us?
I wouldn't worry about that.
Oh, don't be a dick.
No, he just means with a pilly willy and all that.
Pilly willy? What the fuck's that? So, according to Sonny, MDMA shrivels your dick up to the size of a small cat pillar, so that's great. Seems to have left that crucial detail off the Talk to Frank website. I just don't get it. It's meant to make you all lovey-dovey, but you have a dick smaller than a kidney bean until it wears off. What's the fucking point in that? I also don't trust that sellotape's gonna do the trick. Not if there's police dogs.
My
thinking is, if I put the baggie in the condom and then sellotape that to me, then it'll mask the smell for the dogs. You might think I'm overthinking, but if Hannah Fisher's going, I am getting in.
Excuse me, ladies, you're in the habit to have an elf bar by any chance?
He doesn't make it easy, does he? I'm already shitting myself about not getting in, and he's dropping creepy game on a bunch of randos.
I mean, don't be stressed, we're all good, bro, eh?
Did you see that police dog, though? They're trained police dogs. Don't you think they smell hard drugs through a thin layer of sellotape?
It's fine, we've done it every time. Stop being such a pussy.
Unbelievable.
Getting IT ready, by the way, yeah?
Oh, shit, yeah. Nah, chill, I can't find it.
What? Are you getting the fucking piss?
No, it must have fell out when I got that condom out.
What condom?
I put my baggie in a condom and then I sellotaped that to me.
Are you not a looby?
Yes, but that's not a fucking issue right now. I can't find my ID.
And you've not got anything else you can use?
I've got the fake ID I used when I was 17.
Doesn't that say you're a 26-year-old Polish man?
Yeah.
That's not gonna fucking work.
Well, I've got no choice now, have I?
Next. Oh.
Be your help. Anyway.
Cheers.
Hi, mate.
Cheers. Yeah, in you go. Hi, Dishon.
Havel?
Tak.
Lewandowski?
Tak.
Here you go, sir.
Cheers, mate.
Open up your eyes. Time is running out, so find the feeling.
Bum diggy 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 bung diggy bong.
Fucking mad in here, lads. Never seen so many fat girls in one spot.
I mean, who's that absolute tidy you got in the queue as well?
Fuck those. That's why I start sniffing
there. I want to make sure I come up before midnight. Well, it's only 10:30 now, surely you will.
Yeah, probably, but you want to make sure. Where's these toilets?
Over that way.
Let's go.
Yes.
Jerry, look who it is.
Fucking hell, she looks tidy.
Jamie.
Oh, don't shoot yourself, mate.
Hey.
Hiya, how are you?
Yeah, I'm good. What the fuck are you doing here?
What do you mean?
I mean, what are you doing here? I mean, I didn't think this was your scene at all.
Well, it's new for me, but I just thought I'd give it a bash, you know?
Fair enough. Well, it's the same DJ who was here last year, and it was unbelievable, so I'm buzzing.
Yeah, Rob, I heard that as well. Can't wait.
Well, what are you waiting here for? You're not sniffing tonight, are you?
Yeah, actually.
Get you, Jamie. What happened to the lad who used to sit at home every Saturday night with his mum watching Gogglebox?
Yeah, that's not really me anymore, I guess.
Well, I like this new adventure, Jamie. If you're still feeling the same later on, come find me, yeah?
Fuck me, I just saw that though.
Did you see that?
Yeah, I saw that as well, you lucky wee prick.
I don't know why the fuck she'd be into you. She loves going out and buying drugs all the time. And you're a fucking little introvert freak who only goes out once at the blue moon. Even then, it's only to get a takeaway, you daft get.
Yep, good one.
He's right, you are a freak.
Yep, cheers.
Right, are we stuffing our what?
Right. Let's go.
Like, we'll, what now, one at a time?
Nah, we'll double up. Me and this one, we'll go in that one, you two and that one.
Nah, I want to watch Jamie do his first key.
What, you think three of us are fitting in one cubicle? Fucking get in that one. Yeah, let's go.
Fucking hell, lad, it's freezing. It's fucking Baltic. Got the fire on though, made up with that. Check that out. Get out. Get out. Get out! Shut that door! Shut that fucking door! Shut that fucking door! Muppets, twat, little bastard. Fuck that, I'm not fucking going in there. It smells worse than Eric's bathroom.
Oh, it's fine, don't be a pussy again.
Where the fuck is it in there?
To mask the smell.
There's no lubby.
Fuck off! Right, so, what now?
Okay, so, you just cover one nostril, put it on the key, take a big, deep...
Ah, sniff!
What, and then it goes to my brain?
No, you fucking don't. It goes down the back of your throat.
Down your throat? That's fucking grim.
Mate, just do it and find out for yourself.
Thank you.
Sonny, it's looking at my nose.
Do this, this. You're all right.
Fuck's sake. Why does it taste like that? It tastes like gone off diesel.
Just do another one, it gets better.
I'm not fucking doing that again.
Fucking, yes you are, you stop feeling them going down after a while. Just fucking do another one.
Nah, Sonny, I'm genuinely not.
Stop being a fucking pussy and do it again.
Fuck's sake. I don't feel a fucking thing. I've done three keys and I don't feel anything. I'm starting to think that drug dealer who sold me for £50 a gram on a mates rate steal might have been having me on.
Yeah, might as well base up here. It's as good a spot as any.
Lads, I don't feel anything.
Oh, you've only done three little keys. Do some more and you'll be fine.
What? Here?
Yeah, no one gives a shit, do they? Fucking look at those two.
Yeah, mate, I'm doing some more as well.
Oh, now we're fucking talking!
Is this the good DJ?
Yeah, which is precisely why you should do some more. Starts to feel now. Oh, get a bit tingly.
I was about to say the same thing.
Oh, same. Oh. Jamie, how are you feeling? Fucking shy. I just feel a bit anxious and a bit sick.
No change from usual, mate.
Yeah, good one.
Oh, listen, mate, lighten up. Just do a few more keys, you'll be fine.
Sonny, I've done the same amount as you and fuck all has happened. Will you give it a fucking rest?
Mate, calm down, you fucking gimp. What are you trying to help?
Jamie, maybe it's just a bit weak or something. Why not do a bit more, and if you don't come up, well, it's shy and you can just keep drinking.
Yeah, that sounds safe.
Oh, just do it, you pussy!
Fuck's sake.
Yeah, that should do, that should do.
Yeah. Oh, fuck this, I need to fucking sit down. Can I have a pint of water, please, mate?
Oh, sure. You alright, mate?
Really good.
your eyes, Jamie. It's like, no, I fucking dinner plates.
Really? Are they bad?
No, no, they're fine, mate, honestly.
Yeah,
big time.
What did I say?
Where did you go?
Oh, I had to go and sit down. I thought I was going to die.
Oh, shit, are you good now, though, mate?
I'm sound now, mate, yeah.
Love that,
man. Oh, man, I'm so glad you're here tonight, bro. And listen, I better see you with Hannah Fisher by the end of the night.
Oh, I don't know if that's going to offer me. I don't really know if I've got the chance to talk to her.
Don't be daft, of course you do. You're a top one, she knows that. Plus, regardless of what happens, you, me, and these two are going to have the fucking sickest time tonight. Yeah? Good
yeah.
man.
Yes.
That's why I love my mum, you know? Like, it's the small things. Like making me cream and mushroom soup.
I fucking love cream and mushroom soup.
Oh, same. It's the best soup.
Right. I've decided, if I wear my bet tomorrow, I'm taking you boys on a holiday.
Oh,
mate. Yeah, mate, that would be good, mate. I'd
fucking love a holiday with you boys.
Yeah.
Cheers, Oscar. I've got no idea how the conversation just transitioned there, and yet, somehow, it all just made sense. Right, lads, I'm going to the toilets.
Cool, we're just going to go back for the countdown. We'll be in between those two pillars.
Okay, Sam, mate, thank you for letting me know where you're going to be.
God, Hannah! Hannah, what the fuck's happened?
Hannah, are you okay? What have you taken?
I've just drank.
You've just drank? Are you sure? I know you normally like a sniff.
No, I just drank. I don't do that one.
All right, well, I've got some water here for you if you need it. Where are your mates?
I don't know.
Do you want us to go and find them?
Mm-mm. Can you please stay here with me while I drink? I swear I'll let you go before the countdown.
Oh, don't be silly. If you need me, I'm all right staying around here for a bit.
Thanks, Jamie. Where are your mates?
They're in the crowd somewhere, I think.
Here, mate. You haven't got any more chum, have you?
Oh, mate. How are you?
Eric, chewing gum.
Not got any.
See? I feel like I do.
No.
What do you need to talk about before anything?
Mate, if I don't chew something, my fucking lips get all chapped.
Mate, we can't.
So, why tonight to take up drugs?
It's as good as night as any, isn't it?
No, I mean, you. What happened? You're always so decent and sensible and never about to peer pressure. Something's clearly changed your mind. I'm just curious what it is.
I was just thinking about life, I guess, and I'm letting it pass me by.
Bloody hell. I mean, I know people say some, like, deep shit when they're on something, but that's a whole other level.
This isn't the drugs talk, and I'm genuinely just being honest with you.
No, I know. I'm just winding you up.
I mean, like, Out of my own fear and anxiety, I stay in and I don't get up to anything. All my mates go out, they take drugs, they get fucked up, and they have a great time, and they make memories for life. And meanwhile, just because I'm too scared to dabble in anything, I miss out, and it's meant the whole of uni life just whistle past me. I just thought if I went out with them one time and did what they did and took what they took, I'd feel part of it. I just want to feel like one of the boys.
Look, Jamie, take it from me. It's not drugs that makes you one of the boys.
What do you mean?
Like, I get you want to feel included in everything, but these lads were your mates before, right?
Yeah.
Well, if they were your mates before, then they clearly care about you. I mean, for you to stay in as much as you do, and sober as often as you are, and for them to still want to be your friends, you're clearly valuable to them. Like, it's nice that you came out tonight and you feel included in everything, but look at you. You've never dressed like this before, and I've never heard you listen to this kind of music. And I've never seen you licking your lips as much as you are right now. You're trying to change yourself to be more like them when they liked you how you were before.
Should we head back in?
I need to go to the bathroom. Will you come with me?
Yeah, I need it as well. Trust me.
Jamie. Dunno. Hope he's okay.
I'll just be a minute.
Alright. What are you doing?
Okay, look, I just wanted to tell you that I also liked you how you were before. And please, by all means, step out of your comfort zone, but just, like, don't become something you're not.
But earlier tonight you said you liked this adventurous new me.
Yeah, because I never get to see you out, Jamie. I mean, ever since Eric's party last year, I've wanted to see you so bad, but you never show your face.
But I swear you and Sonny got together at that.
What? Sonny, no fucking way. He's a little tramp. I like you, Jamie. I always have.
I like you. Nah, Hannah, don't bother doing that.
What? But you just said...
No, I know what I said, but like, no, I can't do this. Like, not today. I'll tell you what, Hannah's spot on. It's not right me trying to cling to a group of people to be something I'm not. My mates like me for me, and I'm not just gonna have gone out and done drugs with them one time. Besides, my fucking jaw hurts like man, I'm always starting to come down. My brief stint as a drug user might be over with the new year, but I tell you what, nothing's gonna stop me in this new year. I'm gonna get out, I'm gonna make it happen. There is absolutely nothing in this world that could keep me inside.